Students, I welcome you all in today's maths class. And today our topic is multiplication. So dear students, today I will explain multiplication of two digit number by one digit number with carryover and multiplication of three digit number by one digit number with carryover. So let's begin, dear students. Moving on to our sums with carryover, let us recapitulate what is multiplication. So multiplication means repeated addition. Yes, very good. Any number multiplied by 1 is number itself. For example, 4 multiplied by 1 is equal to 4, 40 multiplied by 1 is equals to 40, or 54 multiplied by 1 is also equals to 54. Next is, any number multiplied by 0 is always 0. For example, 4 multiplied by 0 is 0, 40 multiplied by 0 is also 0. Next is, answer of multiplication is also known as product. Yes, sign or symbol of multiplication is cross. Right, next is, number which are multiplied are also known as factors. Dear students, the number which we multiply is known as multiplicand, and the number by which we multiply the multiplicand is known as multiplier. But both the multiplicand and multiplier are also known as factors. Do you know why? Because in multiplication, the numbers can be multiplied in any order. Alright, multiplying two digit number by one digit number with carryover. So dear students, let us understand this concept with the help of an example. So an example is given here in which we will have to multiply 27 by 2. So 27 is our multiplicand and 2 is our multiplier. So let us align our sum first. So in step 1, multiply 7 ones by 2. So dear students, when we will multiply 7 ones by 2, we get 14. Now write 4 in 1's column and carry 1 to the 10th column. After completing step 1, let's move on to step 2. Here, we multiply 2 tens by 2. So, 2 multiplied by 2 is equals to 4. But, we also have to add 1 tens, which is carried over during first step. So, 4 plus 1 is equals to 5. Now, write 5 in tens column. Therefore, 27 multiplied by 2 is equals to 54. So, dear students, when we multiply 27 by 2, the product is 54. And in multiplication, the answer is always known as product. Let's move on to multiplication of 3-digit number by 1-digit number with carryover. So let's understand this, dear students, with the help of an example. So here in this example, we will have to multiply 215 by 3. Here, dear students, by means multiply. We'll have to take out the product. Alright. So first we will align our numbers in the sum. Right. So 215 is our multiplicand and 3 is our multiplier. So we'll have to multiply 3 by 215. So these are also known as factor, dear students. So in step 1, we will multiply 5, which is at the 1's place, by 3, which is our multiplier. So 5 multiplied by 3 equals to 15. Yes. Now what we will do, dear students, we will write down 5 in ones column and carry 1 tens to the tens column and write it down above. After completing step 1, let's move on to step 2. So now we will multiply 1 tens by 3. 1 tens is our multiplicand and 3 is our multiplier. So when we multiply 3 by 1, the answer is 3. Do you know why, dear students? Because anything multiplied by 1 is number itself. Yes. So here we are multiplying 3 by 1. So we get 3 as an answer. So add 1 tens, which is carried over from the first step. That is 3 plus 1 equals to 4. So write 4 in the tens column, dear students. So in our final step, we will have to multiply 2 hundreds by 3. That is 2 multiplied by 3 is equals to 6. So write down 6 in hundreds column. Therefore, 215 multiplied by 3 is equals to 645. So, dear students, when we will multiply 215 by 3, we get our product and that is 645. So, in today's video, we just did multiplication of 2-digit number by 1-digit number with carryover and multiplication of 3-digit number by 1-digit number with carryover. So, dear students, we did this topics with the help of an example. I hope you understood the topic and I want you to practice more and more sums. Thank you.